The first one, first inductee, this is a great honour to be able to acknowledge this. I'd like to invite John Olsen up, who is the chairman of the South Australian Football Commission, who will present the induction certificates. John, thank you. Our first inductee made his debut with the Double Blues back in 1982. Had an amazing career at Sturt. It was short, but it was absolutely fantastic. Back-to-back best and fairest in 84-85. All-Australian selection twice, played some amazing state football, picked up a Foss Williams medal, crossed the border and made an impact in the VFL straight away, playing in a grand final with Carlton in his first year in 1986. Everyone knows that his career was cut short, tragically, at just 22 years of age, but ever since then he's still had a huge influence on football in South Australia. And we see his smiling face at the footy every week for the Double Blues, where he's been the number one ticket holder for a long time. And he even has the oval named after him. I'm, of course, talking about the great Peter Motley. Let's have a look on the screen. Take me over, take me tonight. Dream no more and leave it all behind. Take me over, take me tonight. Dream no more and leave it all. Hello, Mots. Come over here, mate. You're front and centre. It's your stage.
Oh, right.
How are you, buddy?
Good.
Going well?
Yeah, not too bad. Very thrilled to be part of this situation, but I'll rehearse my...
Your speech?
Yep.
Well, before we let you get to the speech, Mots, I want to just take you down memory lane a bit, because we found some wonderful footage of you in action, mate. Congratulations, first of all, for being inducted. I can see your dad over there, and everyone knows that your dad, just a wonderful career with his nine flags and that at Port Adelaide and premiership coach, everything he's done. It must be pretty exciting to know that you and dad are in the same Hall of Fame.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. I can't recall about that situation. Even now, it's I can't believe it, but I don't know.
Well, Mots, as a young man, obviously, you started playing footy for Sturt back in 82.
Yeah.
And, geez, you stormed on. You didn't have any trouble finding your way in league footy, though, did you? You were just about running amok right from the start as a youngster, as a teenager.
Oh, yeah. Well, Dad told me to go for the ball, and he was right.
Some good advice from Dad, and that worked out very well. Mots, we've got some vision of you just as a young man when you were with your dad. Now, of course, obviously, you have a wonderful relationship, and he's been a great support. And we have a look up on the screen here. We've got some shots of you from when you were a young pup. You were always destined to play football, though, no doubt, with your dad being so prominent, weren't you?
Yeah. I was the better-looking one.
Yes.
Well, <I'm> that. Juanita's here, too.
Fantastic. You got the family.
Yeah.
Mots, did you feel pressure because Dad was so good? Or did you just go out and, like you said, he said, just go and get the ball, Pete, because you obviously did that well, but you didn't feel any expectation?
I went to Australian and the opposition selection committee.
Yep.
And Dad was chairman of selectors I just had there and started eating hot chips and schnitzel, chips and gravy. So it was good.
Mots, here's some vision of you playing for Sturt. Now, you took the world by storm. You were taking hangers. You're winning best and fairest as a teenager. You're an All-Australian. Tell us about those early days at the Sturt Footy Club. What were they like? And you obviously had some superstars around you as well.
Great memories of Russell Hutton and Neil Craig. They were good. Witz is there.
Yep.
Where is he?
Yeah, Greg Whittlesey's out there.
Yeah. He was a good snoozer.
Mots, I've got to ask, so when you were, now back in 1982, they had this thing called the Interstate Draft. Yeah. Now, I'm not sure how many people are aware, but back in that draft, there were some big names out of South Australia taken, and you were taken by the Sydney Swans. And I think they even sent David Rees-Jones to have a bit of a chat to you. This is David Rees-Jones. Let's have a look up on the screen.
I went over to Adelaide with a group of us, Barry Round and Mark Browning, Bernie Evans and myself, when he signed a Form 4 with the Sydney Swans. So, gone over to meet Mots and Jeff and the family and that, and to convince them that going to the Swans was the right thing to do.
Well, he couldn't convince you. Were you close, Pete, to go to Swans at that time?
No, I never formed four or anything like that.
No, you just said no from the draft.
No, because Dad handled the situation. Yeah. I was just playing footy.
Did you actually say to Dad, look, I wouldn't mind having a run at the Swans? Because, 82, they'd just gone to Sydney, obviously, that year too.
Yeah. Three years ago.
Yep.
And I was
You weren't too fussed about heading there?
No, but I then David Rees-Jones, who played with Carlton.
Yeah, of course.
Good.
You got to catch up with
him. And Bernie Evans as well.
Mots, I want to ask about state football. Because as a young man, played some wonderful state footy. And even when you walk up the stairs here tonight or you come up the escalator, you see all the state footy and all the greats and many of the boys you played with here and got some vision, obviously, of you playing state football. What was it like? Because it was so big. I know we're not going to see it again probably in our time, but what was it like playing for South Australia?
Oh, it was the ultimate, actually. I can't recall anything because against Victoria was a great thing. And we were number one each time. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The crowds, of course, were massive.
Yeah.
And it was the biggest thing in the game at the time.
There was 110,000 when I was playing for Carlton, Blaine Hawthorn.
In the grand final.
Final. And that's... I better get the footy.
Well, you're good at doing that. There's no doubt about that. When you finally made the move to Carlton, obviously your mate Craig Bradley, he went over. There's some wonderful players. Stephen Kernahan was over. There, just some amazing players out of South Australia. What made you go at that point? Because obviously people have been talking to you about making that move across.
Well, it was the best... SA and NFL, there's a higher
standard.
Standard. So I wanted to, but I still can't believe that Sturt has got me inside, and they got the Peter Motley race.
Yes, absolutely. The ground.
The ground.
Yeah.
Dad had the football.
He's got the race.
At the Adelaide Oval.
Yep.
Here, he's got the race.
Well, you've got one better.
I've got him the old oval.
You got the whole oval. You've got him on a couple of them, mate. Just quickly, I just want to touch one more thing too. In 86, you said, so your first year, you've gone to the VFL.
Yeah.
You've moved in beautifully. You've got Craig Bradley playing with you. You've got Stephen Kernahan. And you're playing against little Johnny Platton, who's here tonight as well in that 86 grand final. Yeah, he's here. Now, I know they got up.
Hard to see him because he's only small.
You said 100,000-odd people, mate. Tell us, you're on the MCG in your first year at that next level up. What was it like? It must have been just amazing.
Oh, it was so shaking. And when the national anthem and all that, so... but at 2 minutes in the game and you're on it, you're on it. So it's...
You were straight into it,
yeah,
Pete.
Yeah, yeah.
Of course, everyone's aware you had the accident at just 22 years of age, and then that year Carlton went on and won the flag.
Yep.
And you were no doubt a huge part of Carlton winning that flag. We've just got some vision from grand final day in 87, if you'd like to have a look up on the screen. The
and when the game was played and won, the boys ran to the boundary and they knew where he was and they all pointed and, you know, held up the medallions and you're part of this. It was a lovely moment.
Lights, Daisy, Bernie, beautiful.
It was pretty crowded down the rooms, and Pete was there when we walked in, which is good. Everyone was giving him hugs, and you know, I'm sure he couldn't have been happier. But in the same breath, he would have been wishing he was out there.
Everyone was standing around Motts and Brattles with the photo, and it was a big moment. He was a huge part of that flag, and it was great that he was there for it. And I won't forget that photo. It was pretty emotional stuff.
Pete, I know it was obviously pretty tough. That's a really iconic photo of you and Craig, and obviously Craig had a lot more hair then than the really nice polished dome we can see now in Craig Bradley.
Yeah, he's the lights go on and he's no hair.
Watts, it was a wonderful moment for the Carlton Football Club, and there is no doubt that you provided an enormous inspiration for those boys to win that flag, mate. Congratulations on everything you've done and your involvement with football since we've seen you at the Sturt Football Club just about every game over the last, you know, 30, 40 years or so forth, mate.
Yeah.
Congratulations to have you inducted. I'm sure there's some people you'd love to thank. Peter Motley, you're a champion,
you.
Mate. Congratulations, buddy.
Okay. Never in my wildest dreams did I believe that such an honour would be granted to me. But reassured, I'm so proud and honoured. This award tonight will be placed in a prominent position in my home for all to see. Without question, I consider that being in the South Australian National Football League Hall of Fame is the greatest achievement of a playing career in South Australia. It goes without saying, my immediate family were always there to guide me through the early years of my football career. My dad and I were very close, as my mother, who in her own right was a top player in netball, representing Australia and captaining of the state team for several years. Along with representing Australia in international rules basketball at 1957 World Championships in Rio de Janeiro. I still remain a proud follower and always grateful for allowing me to represent them in your junior and senior ranks. This award, this honour, remains without doubt the greatest achievement of my football career. I am very humble, but very proud, grateful, and very honoured to receive this award of excellence. I congratulate our McGarry medalist winner this evening and the other inductees, but I wish to assure that can be no doubt that I am tonight to receive this honour. Thank you.